Big Ten football is just about 3 days away. Mark Rogers TV breaking down week one with Harold Shelton. He's a researcher for the Big Ten Network. Harold, appreciate you coming on board today. How you doing?
I'm doing fine. Thanks for having me on. I appreciate it.
Definitely. So we dive into action. We got a little taste of college football last weekend, but the Big Ten, all 14 teams in play in week one. It starts with a big Thursday matchup on ESPN, Ohio State, number two ranked in the country, taking on Indiana. This has been a difficult one for the Buckeyes, and you can't look at 38-17 last year. You got to take in the context of the game. It was a one-score game in the third quarter. Indiana's really given the Buckeyes fits in recent years. Do you have any recent or interesting trends or stats going into this one?
Well, it's just funny seeing Ohio State, Indiana so early in the season. It's the first time we've had a conference game opening week in the Big Ten in 21 years. So just the fact that we're seeing this now as opposed to the end of September is interesting in itself. I know you mentioned that Ohio State has had some issues with Indiana recently. I know they have won 22 straight against them, but I'd say four of the six meetings when Kevin Wilson was the head coach have all been decided like in the last 10 minutes. There was the wild 52-49 game in Urban's first year. Jalen Marshall rescued him a couple years ago when they won a national championship. They needed a goal line stand to beat him the last time they played in Bloomington. So I would say, you know, they need to be careful, especially week one. You never know. A lot of rust they need to work out.
No question. These Ohio State teams were top teams, too. The Jalen Marshall game you mentioned, of course, that team went on to win the national championship. Zeke Elliott had a huge day in Bloomington. And as you mentioned, Indiana's sitting right on the goal line at the end of the game, throwing the ball into the end zone to try to tie or win the game. 34-27 loss against the number one ranked Ohio State team. So the Buckeyes with trouble against the Hoosiers, and we'll see what the Buckeyes have in store with Kevin Wilson, obviously calling the plays for Ohio State. Anything else on the Buckeyes and the Hoosiers?
Yeah, like you mentioned, Kevin Wilson going from one sideline to the other ought to be very interesting. Obviously, these are all his players. You know, he was one of the most successful Indiana coaches that there was, leading them to back-to-back bowl games for the first time since the early 90s. Now you have Tom Allen taking over. It's his first full season, but he at least has some experience since he coached in the bowl game against Utah. So he at least has some experience of trying to get game plans together and this and that. But it'll be very interesting to see what Indiana's offense looks like. Will they still try to keep some of the Wilson aspects? I know they hired Mike DeBoer, who was at Tennessee. It seems like his offense was great when you had a mobile quarterback, which Richard Leggo is not. So I'd be curious to see what the play calling is like. Will they try to still use a lot of the same terminology that they had under Wilson, or will they change it a little bit? And how much will Kevin Wilson expect, considering these are all of his players and he knows all their tendencies?